Hello, it's Jang here with a quick look at the LEGO Dimensions Wizard of Oz Wicked Witch of the West Fun Pack. The figure's base, the NFC toy tag, is fairly nondescript. It just has her crystal ball there in the lime green color. The figure itself is, I believe, the second witch that LEGO has ever made with lime green as the skin tone, the other one also coming out this year. And it's a pretty good looking figure. It has a good expression on it, nice wide evil grin, and nice print. You know, not a lot of color, obviously, for obvious reasons, it's appropriate, but the print is done nicely and it includes a little bit that goes through the hip pieces as well. The hat has no print on it or no coloring, it's all just plain black. The head has no alternate face, but there is a nice matching print on the back of the torso, which is more than it needs, really, because most of the time you're not going to see the back of this figure because of the cape. The companion build is a winged monkey, which is very appropriate for the universe, but it does not look anything like what you actually encounter in-game as an enemy, as the flying winged monkeys. Very early on, actually, in the gameplay. This is actually built up, whereas what you see in-game from as NPCs are all minifigure style, but they made the decision to go with builds as the alternate thing. Never two figures, at least not up to this point, never two figures in a single fun pack. But this, for what it is pretty well done. It's nice to get those large wing pieces in dark gray there. It's a nice little build. It's a little bit abstract, but it's tough to build things in this scale, and I think it actually looks pretty good, and I like how it's posed, not just standing normally. Of course, you can turn the wings in and out. You can turn the wings in and out carefully. It has waist articulation, as you already saw right there, and you can move the arms up and down. So kind of a limited range there, but I'm much more impressed when I consider that this is a 3-in-1 build rather than just looking at this. Using every single piece that's shown right there, you rebuild this. So there's the in-game version for this. You know, they do match it as the player-controlled character add-on thing there. They do match the build, just not for the NPCs. But you can rebuild it into this, the Battle Monkey, which is a different look. But then this second build is even more interesting to me. I like how that looks very much. Commander Monkey gives off, I really like the way that it's holding the horn there, the way that they curve the pieces all the way around. I think that's very nicely done. Other things that are nice to get as far as pieces are concerned here are the medium blue colored cheese slope piece, the little round 1x1 tiles, and also this blue fez. All told, I think the set is pretty nicely done. The witch figure is pretty nicely done. The build for the winged monkey, though, you know, it would look much better as a minifigure. They stuck to their guns. They went with an actual build. They have the 3-in-1 thing going, so that actually works out well. The best thing about this is actually the Wicked Witch of the West character in-game. She's phenomenal. She can do everything that Gandalf can do and a whole lot more. So this actually ends up being a fairly valuable pack to actually use in-game long-term, I believe. So that's my look at this set, and those are my thoughts. Please feel free to share your thoughts by leaving a comment down below. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll talk to you again soon.